I welcome you all to this awareness program on diabetes, and this is being organized by the Department of Students Welfare, University of Kashmir, in collaboration with Department of Clinical Research, Sher-e Kashmir, Institute of Medical Sciences, Srinagar. And this event is being supported by RRR2M Srinagar, Lupin, and Gallimore. Last year, we organized this event online on the same day with the same organization, SKIMS Srinagar. And today, we are offline with a series of events. Before we, ladies and gentlemen, go further proceedings of the function, I humbly request the Dean of Students Welfare, Professor Reyes Ahmed Khan.
It's my privilege and honor to welcome on this occasion, which is very important. The diabetes is a metabolic disorder and a group of diseases which is not being treated, which has no cure, but we manage it with the drugs. Well, today on this occasion, we will have an awareness program on diabetes, and that we talk about the types of the diabetes, and we should talk about the management of the diabetes. So we have a diabetes, type 1, which is found in the younger generation, and type 2 diabetes in the older people, which probably Professor Ashraf Ghani will touch later. And we have gestational diabetes also, which is, reversible. So, in my understanding, our university, especially biological sciences, we have so much of data on MLS, and we've been talking about the anti-diabetic drugs, and we've been talking about the medicinal plants, which could, cure the diabetes metabolic disease. Well, I think let me revisit those theses and let me identify those plants, medicinal plants, which actually inhibits disease, and that we, develop a collaboration between clinicians and non-clinicians, and we have Ayurveda also over here. So let me come up with something. And that we recommend, this program, a recommendation that we submit a recommendation to the government kind of come up with something in the country. With these words, I would like to welcome all of you once again and hope you'll enjoy this event.
It is very important topic that we are discussing, and we are on a very important mission to have this collaboration with SKIMS, particularly to have some sort of training for students who can be a caretaker of diabetes. As we know that many people spoke about diabetes, and I think it is a problem, but at the same time, the problem has to be looked into and tried to be minimized the effect. And for that, it is always better that everywhere you cannot have the doctors to go and take care of the patients. But if we have well-trained people, half the problems are solved, and even people to know that they are suffering, it is very important. At the same time, on the lighter side, I am a diabetic patient. Professor Ashraf Ghani Saab has been treating me, but I have been surviving. Okay, so it's always better to have prevention than cure. Cure baad mein aata hai. Agar aap usko pehle hi prevent kar le, aadhi cheeze usko control ho jati hain, so things will be better. And who else can do better than your own local participants, those people who know the local people, the language, and also the difficulties. So I'm very hopeful that this type of program is going to be very useful for the UT to start with. And then, obviously, Kashmir University and STIMS have been doing this sort of collaboration on very, very different aspects. But I think that this is one of the most important aspects that we have been doing. I do agree with our registrar, because he is a sociologist, that even not only diabetes. See, I am from an earth science background, and I know that we have lots of disasters, we have landslide and lots of things, climate change and falafala. The scientists can do lots more in terms of research and output of research. But the people from social sciences, they are better communicators. So, I don't think that it is very difficult task even for our people, because the general intelligentsia of Kashmir is, mashallah, quite good compared to other parts of the country. So even people with social science background, if they are given this sort of training, they will be excellent people to take home what we want to do for the society. So first batch, most welcome with only science background, but later we should think about to involve in other. Maybe you have to change the module slightly, or maybe one science and one social science make combination and then send them to the field. They will be very useful for the society.
When Dr. Ashraf was saying that it is more a social problem now, I was thinking that he has been influenced by sociology being a long friend of mine. So, but it is probably also when I have also gone through certain papers, I also saw that it has now, this disease has got a lot of social dimension is also. The number of people who are now infected with this disease, and he was talking also about the aspects which the society is facing now. I probably myself also feel that it will definitely disturb the whole social structure of the world, not only of India when we talk of the developed countries like Asia, but also the whole world social structure. When we see that any person, few aspects of the social life which are being disturbed by the diabetic patients who are suffering from diabetes, one is that the social life of the people who are suffering from the diabetes, they get affected also. Because a person who is a diabetic, his social life, his friends, his colleagues, his family, his relatives, definitely he is he gets less interested in interacting with them, and ultimately his life, social life also gets disturbed by this disease. At the world level, second aspect, we see that not in the Asian countries, but normally in the world, there is a procedure of adoption for the as children. What I was going through some books that it has also got affected, because they also check now whether the child is from a diabetic family or he is himself or herself suffering from any kind of such disease. Again, I was reading that another aspect, the social aspect which is getting disturbed with the disease is the immigration aspect. Particularly, Australia was earlier also, they were not allowing the people who were suffering from the diabetic. Now the diabetic society of world has probably sorted it out. So this is another aspect which gets disturbed by this disease. Again, the most important aspect is about the marriage nowadays, which is getting affected by this what Ashraf was talking about, the social aspect of such diseases. Because now particularly a girl is suffering from a diabetic, now it is a issue that if she can carry for a pregnancy or not. That is also been, if it is not so prevalent in the Asian countries, but probably it is seen in the developed and developing countries as well. then the most crucial aspect of diabetes as a social problem is now probably the old age, diabetes in the old age. Because you know that already the world is suffering through the issue of rehabilitation and taking care of the old age people, because what morbidity and this life expectancy at present is concerned at the world over, it has gone quite high now. And that is a issue now, because the old age people now suffer because of the other issues, what doctors were just talking about the diabetic foot and other diseases which are associated with this disease. That is also an aspect which has come to my mind at present. These are certain social issues. Then because being a registrar here, I have to look at the administrative issues also. When we see that the people who are suffering from the diabetes, for example, they normally remain less productive, rather they become unproductive at present in the administrative level, because most of the people, most of the employees who are suffering from the diabetes, they say they ask for a soft posting, they ask for some other concessions in the administration. That is a toll which we are going to have on the administrative level. Then the aspect of economy which is associated with this disease, that is also there, which we need to take care.
One of the serious problems that world is facing at present is the diabetes, and the present session is all about this disorder. Scientists, concerned scientists here in the session, they have been deliberating in these conferences, seminars, discussions about this disorder. But this day which we are celebrating at present here in this auditorium, it is just to have a look on the statistical figures which are quite disturbing. You see, an alarming proportion of the population world over is involved in this. And another figure which is very disturbing, that is the number of deaths which annually take place because of this disorder. Of course, there are different types of diabetes, the type 1, type 2. Many of you might be knowing about those things. The metabolic disorder, we won't be, say, touching that, being not from the field, we won't be touching or discussing about that. But some other, say, preventive measures, which are very much within our hands. You see, there was a time when a significant proportion of the world population used sleep with this thing in mind, that how to fill their belly next day. And presently, you will find that a significant proportion of the population, they go to bed with this thing in mind, how to cut down our calories tomorrow or next day. So those things which are within our hands to control this, our lifestyle, that plays an important role in that. We have seen that the sedentary lifestyle, which has created a havoc, we don't care about what should be our daily calorie intake and what should be the proportion of calories we should burn every day. Majority of us, I should say 99% of our population, we are ignorant about all these things, calorie intake and calorie expenditure. We don't know anything about that. Hum apne aap ko padhe likhe kehlane wale log, we too are unaware about all these things, calorie intake and calorie expenditure. I think those of us who have a mandate, a professional mandate, to get engaged with the society, I think this is a very important aspect we should work on, we should take into consideration. Bazabta ek lahe amal murattab karna hai. how to educate the general population about it. We recently we have signed a memorandum of understanding with Sheri Kashmir Institute of Medical Sciences, wherein Dr. Mohammad Ashraf Ghanai played a pivotal role. Sir, we extend our hand of cooperation to Sheri Kashmir Institute of Medical Sciences. There are different departments in the university which can directly get engaged in this type of activity, in the faculty of these sciences, biological sciences, or social sciences. We can identify departments, and even the Department of Social Welfare, we can join hands with Sheri Kashmir Institute of Medical Sciences to educate the general population about how to bring changes in our lifestyle, be it calorie intake, calorie expenditure, or in general food intake, or the types of foods. Say, we are unaware about the facts which foods have low glycemic index. Say, we may be taking two types of equal quantities of two different types of foods containing similar number of calories, or their content of number of calories may be same in both these types of foods, but one type of food may result in lower blood glucose level compared to another. So a lot of work is nowadays going on all over the world, even in India, about say our staple food, not only ours, but a significant proportion of the world, they consume rice, or rice is their staple food. And a lot of work is being conducted in different laboratories, especially those who are engaged in breeding these field crops or rice breeding. They work on rice varieties which have low glycemic index, or to put it other words, those varieties which are high in amylose content. Those of us who are from biological sciences background, they know, say, rice is a major source of starch, and then starch has those two fractions, one is amylose and one is amylopectin. The varieties which contain more amylopectin, they have higher this glycemic index. But those varieties which have higher amylose content, they have low glycemic index. So a lot of work is being conducted in Indian laboratories also about breeding of varieties which have high amylose, or which have low, which result in low glycemic index of cooked rice. So with these things, I once again offer the services of our university to collaborate with Sheri Kashmir Institute of Medical Sciences to bring awareness about this particular disorder, and what are the preventive measures which are very easy for us to work on. With these words, I thank you very much.
Since last one decade, we have been in a position to carry out so many programs in the nook and corner of the valley. These programs are in terms of capacity building, awareness generation, but by and large we have been unifocal in our activities in launching vocational courses in the nook and corner of the valley. In different areas, under different sectors, it may be IT sector, it may be automotive sector, it may be media and entertainment sector, it may be construction sector, it may be textile sector. We have got jobs for self-employed, and some are working within the valley, and some others are working outside the valley. And most of these trainees have come out of the effort, come out of the comforts of salaried jobs. They have established their own units. They have become entrepreneurs. And they have not only become the job seekers, they have become the job creators, and which is the need of the hour.
I will laud the efforts of our Dean, University of Kashmir, Masoodi Saab, as well as Dean from Dean and Director of SCIMS. They have been actually encouraging me and supporting me for executing some MOUs with this institution. I think both our these institutions have tremendous capacity, but we work on different lines. If we have a cooperative attitude of cooperativity and we collaborate, I think we can complement each other, and it will pay dividends to our community as well as in academics. As has been rightly said by Professor Kadri as well as Masoodi Saab, diabetes mellitus is a global issue. All of us are aware of this fact. But let me put you through little bit of the arena around diabetes. So diabetes is not a single disease or a single homogeneous disorder like it is appendicitis and we treat it like that. No, it is a disorder which has a gamut of metabolic complications, a constellation of metabolic complications associated with it. It is not just glucose. Even doctors today, or even patients think in terms of glucose-centric goal. They think we have to just reach the target of glucose, job is done. It is not that. We have to understand it in a different and a broader perspective. Diabetes is just not a medical disease, it is a social disease. It has engulfed our society. How is that? If you see, there has been a mortality and morbidity data by WHO. In all the higher income countries, developed countries like America, Europe, they have been able to reduce the mortality burden as well as morbidity burden by dint of vaccinations and antibiotics. But in lower and middle income countries like ours, we still have significant toll of deaths because of malnutrition, I mean undernutrition, and still there are significant number of deaths because of because of communicable diseases like infections. You must have seen the havoc created by the COVID-19. So that is why vaccinations are still not being done at 100% rate in our countries. Nutrition is not being given to the underprivileged areas. So because of that, we still have a big toll of diseases happening in this country.
So we are here today, diabetes. This we celebrated it, I think, 2 days back in Skims. Very interesting subject. All families are involved. In fact, I am treating my father. He is at the age of 90 now. He is a diabetic and type 2 diabetes for the last 35 years. And I treat him myself. And every day I see him in the morning because I give him breakfast myself. It's a wonder to see him live. How can you control diabetes? Some of the best brains I have found is here, diabetics, especially our diabetologists, the Department of Endocrinology at SKIMS has been doing a wonderful job. And they have unanimously decided to hit these diseases together. And how proudly we say that we are collaborating with the University of Kashmir, which is a hub of knowledge. For us, this is an ocean. And collaborations get success finally. The majority of people get treated, they get satisfaction. We have come for a short time in this world. Nobody is going to live. There's a cell death, what we call. Nobody can conquer cell death. But then the quality of life, what we call QOL, that's what matters. How do you spend your day? Time is written. The birth is written, the death is written. But the quality of life, the acceptance, and the knowledge which at that particular time happens in your environment, you got to acquire that. So that is the story of success. And in all these things, the human being wants to be the best, get the best out of this world. So this is a very important burning topic. And it is a topic which is mountaining. Again, it is going up all over the world. But then the knowledge will allow you to have a good day.